Now that we've motivated the vision, let's see how we can implement the vision. In order to implement this vision, the operating system should provide quality of service APIs to the application. And these quality of service APIs could be things like, oh, this particular network flow that I'm creating has certain real-time constraints because it has video data and so on and so forth. And those are the hints that the operating system is going to use in terms of synthesizing code that corresponds to the API that the operating system is providing you to give hints to the network. So the code that the operating system is going to synthesize is essentially taking the quality of service constraints and putting them as executable code that can be then passed around as part of the packet. So in other words, the protocol stack of the operating system has to be enhanced to service these quality of service requirements and generate or synthesize the code that has to be part of the payload. So the application is not only providing a payload, but it is giving quality of service constraints, and the operating system, in addition to the payload, generates or synthesizes code corresponding to this quality of service instructions, and then slaps on the IP header for where this particular message is eventually to be delivered and hands it over to the internet. And in the internet, if you assume that the internet routers are capable of executing the specialized code, then depending on the nature of what is being requested, a particular router may say, oh, this particular packet, I have to send it to multiple destinations, so let me send it down this link. And similarly, when it comes over here, this router may say, oh, this particular packet has to go to multiple destinations, and so on. And that way, we can see that intelligent routing decisions can be taken in the network. That's sort of the roadmap of how we can take this vision and try to implement it. But the problem with carrying out the vision in terms of this implementation that I just sketched is that changing the operating system is non-trivial, especially the protocol stack. As I already mentioned, TCP/IP has several hundred thousand lines of code. So it is non-trivial to change the protocol stack of every node in the entire universe to handle active networks. And also the second part of the challenge is that the network routers are not open. So in other words, we cannot expect that every router on the internet is capable of processing the code that I'm going to slap on to this payload and be able to make intelligent routing decisions. So there is an impedance mismatch between the vision and the implementation that I've sketched right here.